Hello, everyone, and welcome to this, our fourth in our series of five Tuesday noon organ recitals here at St. David's. My usual update every week is that this is a program of the American Guild of Organists Philadelphia chapter, been going on for decades and decades. Our archivist, who's sitting here, will probably be able to answer all your questions about the history. And we have chapters all over the world, and the American Guild of Organists is 125 years old, and the Philadelphia chapter is the oldest chapter. For these Tuesday noon concerts, the members of the Guild offer their time and talent, and some of the finest organists in our area will give these recitals, and here at St. David's, that's been no exception. Also, I will invite you to lunch afterward in the Harrison Room, which is located all the way on the other side of the building complex, but just go through all the hallways. Most importantly, I'd like to introduce our organist for today. I first met Hannah in 2005 in Baltimore, where she had come to attend one of our pipe organ encounters, which is a program for young people that the AGO sponsors, and she was a student, and I was very fortunate enough to find out that she was a student at Bryn Mawr College, and she was interested in continuing her studies of the organ, so I taught her while she was a student at Bryn Mawr. She may have been the only organ student to come out of Bryn Mawr College before or ever since, and she has a particular affinity for early music. I think you'll really enjoy her program. So let us welcome Hannah Albrecht.
Thank you. That was Bach's arrangement of music by his contemporary, Vivaldi, and Bach's arrangement was actually only written about 2 years after the original was published, so truly contemporary music in that time. The next piece is another one of Italian origin, but with a very different character. This is by Carlotta Ferrari, a prolific current composer who has hundreds of works, choral and organ and other keyboard works, available online. She describes her style as a personal language that blends past and present, so a good counterpoint to these other pieces, I think. And after this serene pastoral, back to another change of pace with quintessential Bach set of variations on an Easter hymn.
Thank you.
The next piece, the oldest piece on the program, is by Jan Pieterszoon Swaelinck, was one of the foremost, well, probably the foremost organist of his time. Played for his whole life at the same church in Amsterdam, which at the time had population around 30,000. It's about like Wayne. but he was not an employee of the church because the city became Calvinist when he was young and forbade organ music in church services. So his entire life he was employed by the city to play recitals like this. I've read daily recitals. I don't know if it was really every day, but he often improvised variations on both hymns and secular tunes. So I'm playing one of the sets of variations on a hymn tune. You'll hear the tune in long tones in each section. It moves through the different parts, from the soprano to the tenor. You'll hear it in each part in turn, and other themes weave around it, becoming increasingly complex. The tune itself is self-explanatory, translates to "Give peace, Lord, in our time."
Thank you.
Just a final word. Thank you all for coming and to have an opportunity to meet Hannah and to have lunch. So please join us over in the Harrison Room. And hopefully look forward to seeing you next week when we have our last recital with Mib Campbell. Thank you for coming.